guys, we're Gabriel, and welcome to my FIFA 17 Liverpool Crow. It's here. It's actually here. It's FIFA 17. It's here. I don't believe it. It feels like forever. It actually felt like forever. The way it felt like forever. You have no idea how much FIFA I crammed into today. I am looking forward to a nice rest once I finish up here. And do in the preseason a secondary career mode. Hey, yes! You do see David Alaba. Before you type, he said he wouldn't do unofficial transfers. This is an official transfer. Paid 55 million! From a new boy. He hit the left side of the fence. Replaced Alvaro Moreno with someone who was actually a defender. No offense to James Milner as he captains the side today. You're probably wondering, if you're wondering where the hell is Jordan Henderson? Stoke. That's where he would be. Yeah. Stoke bought Jordan Henderson for 28 million. So he's gone. So is Adam Lallana. He went to Real Madrid. Yeah, Real Madrid bought Adam Lallana for some reason. 31 million. So, yeah, fantastic. With Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain. The only downside is who's in the Arsenal lineup today. Unfortunately, it's Emerick Laporte day. I was thinking whether I should sign him or not, but I want to give Matip and Lovren a go. And yes, I did say Matip and Lovren. That idiot Sacco, who can now run his big mouth at Hoffenheim. I traded his ass for Sewell, who's waiting patiently for his opportunity. Firmino, no one getting in the box, of course, because why would they?
Gain some experience here if his manager picks him every week.
This match was batshit crazy in real life, and then for. There you have the Liverpool one, and they were winning, and then Arsenal pulled two goals back. And Liverpool are winning this time. It's Emre Can, who was looking like he wasn't going to get into the squad until suddenly Stoke decided, yeah, we want a bit of Jordan Henderson in our team. So, Emre Can is now a star. I was going to rotate him anyway, but Emre Can makes my decision to put him in seem like a very good one, and it was a very good one. And the German opens the FIFA 17 account with the very first Premier League goal. Good for you. And Daniel Sturridge was not sold. Divo Origi and Sadio Mane, who I did convert to a striker, I'll admit to that. I did convert Sadio Mane to a striker. I actually managed to do it as well. I was like really disappointed when I saw I couldn't actually set him to be a striker because it was like when I went to change him from a right mid because I'm playing the 4-2-2-2, with two center defensive mids. So technically, yeah. Chan and James Milner will be playing out position, but shouldn't be any bother to him because center defensive mid is Chan's original position. It's only a little and considering Milner is playing as left back in real life, he's playing as a central defensive midfielder, shouldn't even phase him, to be honest. But, Daniel Sturridge has not been sold. He's waiting on the bench if called upon. But Timo Kuriki showed such form in preseasons, scored in almost every game, and finished top goal scorer. Or even bagging a hat trick in one game and a brace in another, and like just a handful of goals. And there's a goal. Oh, but that's not Timo Kuriki, it's his strike partner, Sadio Mane! Sorry about that. I didn't expect that goal. But yeah, Sadio Mane opens his Liverpool account. And Wenger looks worried. And old. Seriously. How is it Wenger looks older in FIFA than he does in real life? I mean, Wenger looks old in real life, but his wrinkles, maybe they just stand out more because of the Frostbite engine. And might I add, how badass FIFA 17 looks. The demo looks amazing, but the full game looks even better.
So adventurous, aren't they? And they're taking one or two chances, leaving one or two gaps at the back.
I am just loving life. Having a little, I found a few difficulties, these few defensive mishaps during preseason, so hopefully I can make sure that those, something like that doesn't happen during the season, although likely to. Let's be honest here. Sadio Mane! Hey! Oh! I thought Cech was way too close to him to take the shot. I was trying to square to Divo Origi or someone coming in. Maybe I should have taken the shot, but 2-0 lead considering we were 1 down at halftime. No, wait. We went in at 1-1. Coutinho's amazing free kick. Happened before the break. Sure. And can I just say that the pundits on Sky Sports or Gillette Soccer Saturday are a bunch of idiots and have apparently short-term memory loss. Why do I say they have short-term memory loss? Kevin De Bruyne scored a free kick recently and he rolled it under the wall. And they said they hadn't seen anything like it. Actually, yes, you have. Phil Coutinho scored a similar goal in Liverpool's West Ham FA Cup fixture last season. And yet you say you didn't see anything like it. You are a bunch of idiots with short-term memory loss. Or you're just not. You're just plain stupid. So, yeah, got that off my chest. They completely blanked the fact that that happened. For whatever reason. And, has anyone else noticed that something weird about the computer's kickouts in career mode? I don't know if anyone else is having this, but almost every single kickout seems to be short. I don't know what it is.
Alexis Sanchez.
Maybe it's just early game and I'm just noticing nothing. It's just the computer. I mean, it's on legendary, so the computer should be smart enough not to do something stupid like I just did. Carries, pick it up. Thank you.
So we'll restart with a throw-in. Mesut Ozil. A lot of defenders defending the goal, but they still got the ball. Comes in with a
good tackle, Nathaniel. Will keep Sanchez well away from our goal. He has been very good for Arsenal so far. For him, his more for Offensive roll! Oh! Oh, I got away with it! I somehow got away with that! I probably should have conceded a penalty, but the Arsenal player, either I missed him, or he didn't sell the tackle. Cool. If he goes down, he probably gets a penalty. So either the Arsenal player is completely messed up, or I completely missed my tackle. Fantastic. And I blocked the sub and fall shot as well, which is even as well good. Origi. Damn Alaba. Can shoot from long range with the corner. Ramsey. There we go, my first on-camera 3-for-17 corner. It's cleared, but goes to Joe Matip! Oh, straight better shit. I probably should've just, like, over the top, that into the box. Sayo Mane! Oh! Freaking American Laporte, remembering! No wait, that was Koscielny. I thought that was American Laporte remembering his time at Liverpool last FIFA. And still crossing Arsenal, it was Koscielny.
We're into 9 minutes now.
He who made the mirror. Sayo Mane. Put back. Coutinho! Oh, fucking Koscielny, bastard. He makes up for his mistake. Firmino. Maybe pushed off the ball referee? No? Really? Okay, fair enough. Coutinho! Oh, yes! Oh, it's James Milner for the win! James Milner bags the third, and it's a 3-0 victory! Ivo Origi to Coutinho for the Milner. He had to, almost like, pull his leg back, because he was like ahead of them. Oh, also, amazing adjustment there from the new captain. And he wraps up the game in style. That is a great way to return to the FIFA 3-0 victory over, but let's be honest, top four for our entire rival is Arsenal.
And he's got the ball away from him with the tackle.
There will be a minimum of 3 minutes.
They're on the move now.
So yeah. Brilliant. Oh, it might be better, even better. Sadio Mane, surely 4-0. Yes, yes, get in, Sadio Mane. And a 4-0. Oh, and Sadio Mane. He bags himself a brace on his Liverpool debut. Oh, that's brilliant.
Well, he is his own harshest critic, this lad, and he'll blame himself for that, I think, having got a touch.
And that's supposed to be me. That looks nothing like me, unfortunately. The only thing that's similar is the hair. Or colour, to be honest. But they didn't have any pasty white Irish avatars, so unfortunately, he, like a discount Michael McIntyre for his, what my avatar looks like, weirdly enough. Arsene Wenger goes off in this cup. Look at all those rings. Apparently Firmino had a quiet game. Look at that, 9.5, 9.6, 8.9. Oh, the gap. Seriously, only one person was below 8. Fantastic. No need to change it for the Burnley game and all. And Bournemouth beat Manchester United. That's much better than what the real high scoreline was. What the hell? this would never happen. This would never happen. Where is the realism? Although, saying that, I don't think Bella Alba is joining Liverpool anytime soon. But Barcelona would never bid for Dejan Lovren. Okay? They would never bid for Dejan Lovren. 34 and a half? I guess 34 and a half, and they can have him. And I guess Nico Sue goes into his spot. Yeah, right, no. And I'm up to 82 rated, fantastic. And on top of the league, well, that's no surprise. Also, see this guy, Cedric Feor? Remember that name, ladies and gentlemen. It will be important later. Why? Well, let me show you. Oh, that's not right. Look at that. Potential 80 to 94. Current rating 62. Age 15. This kid could be unreal. Oh, if I can get him to his full potential. I don't know how I'm going to fit him. And I really want to use Seojo to the best of his ability. But this kid. And plus, he's my youth player. I only have to get him up 5 ratings throughout the season. And he has to only play 5 matches. Which is fantastic. That will happen. And in no time. I don't know when he becomes 16 so I can play him in those 5 matches, but we're only getting into a game number or 2 in the season, so I won't worry about it. I went up to an 83. How did I go up to an 83? I just simulated one day and apparently I'm at 83. Fantastic. Something good must have happened. Let's see. Very popular shirt sales of David Alba. I like the title store just selling shirts he didn't even play in that game. And Lloris Karius. That was actually his debut as well. Literally. Because he got injured before the career mode started, I had to use Minulay to my disdain. Well, I only used Minulay once. I was actually using Maniger. And to be honest, maybe he was the problem, but I didn't have any outstanding issue with him. I mean, I can see a few goals, but nothing too major or that I would complain about Maniger. I realize I'm probably saying his name wrong. And yes, I did just reject a bid from Hulfer. And there's probably a lot of you sitting there like, wait, you hate Minulay. You want to get rid of him first chance you get. Okay then, fair enough. Oh, that's not a shock. That is really not a shock. I don't know why it's saying it's just shock. It's only a matter of time before he leaves Manchester United. If they hadn't got Jose Mourinho, I guarantee you he'd already be gone. And Man United fans know it. So that's a bad sign. Also, yeah. Also, this game is still set for Turf War. Fair enough. I don't care about these other games. I'll always start paying attention to other teams when we get like mid-November or I know who I'm going to be dealing with in terms of the title. Probably going to be Man City. Maybe Chelsea, because it's almost always Chelsea. They're almost always up there. Braga Car, Arsenal, Manchester United. Maybe the Spurs. Who knows? We'll see. We'll see who's up there. But despite their recent bizarre result against Celtic, Man City still look unbeatable. And unfortunately, Pep Guardiola is starting to turn Raheem Sterling into a player who might actually end up being worth the $50 million.
Two important goals last time out. Really good.
It's a wonderful. Which us Liverpool fans, oh, we will never hear the fucking end of.
After that promotion campaign, wonderful stuff. And
our issue is not that we don't think Sterling wasn't worth the $50 million. If he had developed more, he would have definitely been worth $50 million.
They need a good start, but okay.
Oh, for fuck's sake!
You see what he was trying to do, Alan, with that slide.
I'm legitimately surprised it's not a red card, because that would just go swimmingly. He whipped my luck at the start of this match. It's Andre Gray. Damn it! First goal conceded, and of course it's against Burnley. I went the right way and all. Maybe if I hadn't taken this step over, but I was trying to lure him into 100% going that corner. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't.
David Alaba crosses in.
And this is becoming eerily similar to real life, isn't it? Burnley up in the first few minutes. And I'm furious is about that.
Barnes. And it's now with Liverpool. Doing well to keep the ball.
Not to worry. Sadio Mane! Oh! Quick, go back. Emre Can.
They're grateful for that, to have an intervention like that, get back on the ball when they're defending so much. Mane. Boyd. Ben Mee. Gray. Nice return pass. Well, it was a foul, but Burnley can play on. They've still got the ball. The advantage applies.
Come on.
Short passes, keeping the ball. Looked very good indeed, but the move has broken down.
Alaba.
Challenges for the ball.
Coutinho.
Coutinho.
Go on, Phil. Oh, lovely 1-2 after with Emre Can and Coutinho bearing down on the box. Divo Origi.
Great passing.
Try and get the space. Try and get the options.
Milner.
James Milner. Oh. That would be perfect, to be honest. That would be like the ultimate of redemption. Hey! Someone didn't take a freaking short thing. Maybe because Mane was bearing down on the defense. But either way, he didn't take it short. But it might not matter. Or Divock Origi. He. Aww, the defender. Or God. What in the what? A good block.
Mane.
Karius will claim that, thank you very much.
This is.
Not playing very well there, but. Coutinho.
They've got to dig a bit deeper.
Sadio Mane.
Player to make this
free kick!
The referee's given them a free kick.
That is dangerous. That has to be a yellow card for me.
It's yellow from the ref. Oh, without question.
I don't know if I'm glad or pissed off that that's free kick. I'm pretty happy because, and look who it is. It's James. He does get his redemption. Devin Alaba gets his first contribution since joining Liverpool. He gets an assist just in his second game. And James Milner has his second Premier League goal already. And he's made up for accidentally giving away the penalty for the first for Greggy's opener. So other than the fact that it's one more, all is good.
It's great.
Well, not if you're Sean Dyche. He's probably like, for fuck's sake, we were so close. That was the breaks, dude.
To ooze around the crowd for a 3-minute add-on, which is what we're going to get for added time.
Oh. Oh, what a goal! Freaking hell! Are Burnley going to be a bogey team or some shit? What the hell is this?
Half time now, and 2-1 if... Well, we're going to get some thrills in the second half.
Barnes. But for sure, because it's still very wet out. Burnley back in the lead. The instant response here as soon as the second half starts. Oh, freaking hell, that was almost an own goal from Keane.
Following that good tackle. And he's met it with his head.
Oh, just over the bar from Sadio Mane.
May have been a training ground routine that worked pretty well until the shot.
If I need an extra attacking option, I might bring on Daniel Sturridge in this game. Uh-oh.
Good position here. Makes a challenge here.
Might have to bring on an extra defender to deal with this Burnley onslaught. I can't remember the last time.
And now he's looking for some support.
A team gave me this much trouble. That's the team Liverpool slipped up against so far in real life. I say so far because they played Swansea tomorrow. Well, there's still a possibility. Firmino! Oh, Coutinho! He and his, well, he probably would have liked. That's a shame.
Well, just a chance to tell you about a confirmed transfer here, Matt.
No one cares.
Moved on to Bayern Munich. Yeah, and I think both parties
are
absolutely delighted. I think he'll have a successful career at his new club, and around £45 million. I think that's money well spent.
Mm-hmm.
Here's Gray.
One. Just look for position. Get the ball. Good header from Nathaniel Klein. Go, Sadio Mane! Yes! 2-2! Surely! Sadio Mane! He re-equalizes his for Liverpool!
Well, very nicely placed, Alan. Beautifully done. Yeah, he's almost passed it in.
That's three goals now. Oh, three and two games, I should say. I almost said two and two games for some reason.
Cut out.
After James and very equal. Continue play on. Play on. Might be an opportunity for Bruno Firmino. Yes. No. Yes. Is he? He's onside. Continue. Yes. Get the fuck in.
That is delightfully taken. Well, the keeper, quite rightly, is disgusted with his defenders.
Firmino with the flashy stuff. Phil Coutinho, he'll never miss from there. Or not with his quality. And Phil Coutinho, who puts me in the lead. That is the best time to score your first goal of the season, Phil. Thank you very much.
Well, plenty of goals here today. 3-2.
Whoo!
Ben Mee.
I wonder if the Burnley player was booked after that. No, the player were on. Oh, what I can tell you, Sam Mane scores again, and it is 4-2. Well, 2-4, but you get what I mean.
Well, scoring in any game is worthy of celebration. When you get two, it is special, and he is feeling that.
Sam Mane has 4 goals in 2 games. He is on fire. And I'm wearing a coat, and it's not even a Liverpool coat. What the hell? Give me a Liverpool coat, for fuck's sake. Why is it a Premier League coat?
Prospect of even more goals. 4-2 is the score.
I mean, when Jurgen Klopp wears a coat, he wears a Liverpool coat, for fuck's sake.
Take a note of the time and place of this game on EA Sports, of course. Watch it with us. The EFL Cup fixture. Liverpool, they'll be facing Spurs away from home. Yeah, I've heard a lot of supporters get excited about it, and I am as well.
Firmino.
Have to score, and they have to score soon.
Oh. Been much better in the second half. Roberto Firmino wins the corner? No. Apparently, it's a goal kick.
Well, that's what substitutes the four to be used. And we've got one coming on now. And on the clock, 8 more minutes.
And boy, who managed to get that goal kick. Kick from Firmino. I won't play any further part in this match. Which is a bit, which has to be very disappointing for Boyd, considering he scored and Burnley beat Liverpool in real life. He scored one of the 2 goals as well as Gray. Now the man who did score the second goal in this match for Burnley, Barnes, he just went off.
Minutes from the referee by the fourth official. That's the decision regarding added time. But we're down to the last minute here. Tackle here.
Get rid of it, Matip. Thank you. Not going to come the same, unfortunately. But it doesn't matter, as there is the full time whistle, and that is how to open the Premier, the first FIFA 17 video. Damn! Twists and turns. Don't say I don't bring you the best content ever, because I do.
Leicester City 1, Arsenal 1.
And I went up again! Fantastic! Yeah! It's like an overall or some shit. I go up when I do well, and I go down if I do bad. Fantastic. That's what it is. It's a manager overall.
Everton 2.
In the next episode, I'll have a doubleheader of Spurs. Because reasons. Until then, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button for the first FIFA 17 video. And join me tomorrow for the first episode of the secondary career mode. When you find out who it's with. Until then, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy it. Until next time, hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.